Maybe I should have fought left instead of right. Let's try that again.
Let's get to Abner before the moon's completely alive.
Align with the ancient gate. The lattice opens a path to Jode's core. What? How did you get the dragon horn? Where's Garishri? And why are the sounds of battle so close? Did the Euraxians overrun our defenses? Garishri? Hurt? And the Euraxians behind our defenses? This is not good. Not good at all. Well, we still have the dragon horn. At least until the power runs out or the fragile relic falls apart. Ah, I just wish the moons would move for me. The power, yes, but not the knowledge and experience. I will continue to try to move the moons and close the gate, but you will need to keep the Euraxians from taking this position. I am counting on you, Five Claw.
Ah!
No, Fighter! Not yet! Through the portal, both of you! And bring the dragon horn!
Chimera, wait!
Claw, we stand on the sacred plain of Jode. The dragons went down into the processional. They seek to breach Jode's core. From the memories I absorbed at the Shadow Dance Temple, Anequina and the Moon Priests came here to honor the moons and set them on their way after their sacred joining. This is also where she helped Kunzari hide the dragon's power. Here, on the plain of Jode, the memories become clearer with every passing moment. Kunzari was able to use Khalgronti's own greed against him. The dragon sought the power of Jode's core from the beginning, but Kunzari offered him even more. He offered a way to combine the natural power of Jode's core with the mystic might of his loyal dragons. Khalgronti's greed was his undoing. Now, he finally has an opportunity to steal all the stored energy for himself. We must stop him!
Thank you.
Avoid Mulamnir as best you can.
Is close. I can feel it.
Near Calgrontide and Jode's core. Are you ready for this, Chimera? Calgrontide is absorbing Jode's core. As long as the moons remain aligned, the power flowing through him is unimaginable.
Get me to that platform, Tarn. I can separate the moons using the altars. You must deal with Mulamnir Fiveclaw. I will divert whatever energy I can into the Dragonhorn, but use it sparingly.
You dare to face me, mortal? and die! Assist me. dogs left.
The ritual. John and Jade, hear me.
The power, it belongs to me.
You did it, Chimera. You ended the eclipse.
No,
that means...
The moon gate has closed. We are trapped, yes. But Volamir is dead, and Count Grontit has been defeated.
Oh, hello. You always find things in the last place, you know.
I'm actually pleased to see you, Cadmon. Come, Chimera. Your people await their queen.
Thank you, my friends, for everything.
Queen Chimera, have you been injured?
I am fine, just tired. But look, the moons are no longer aligned. Tell me about the dragons, the Euraxians. What is the state of our forces?
Our scouts tell us that most of the Euraxians and dragons fled when the moons parted. Our own troops have not returned, but the Main has sent an envoy.
An envoy from the Main? If you'll excuse me, I have other business to attend to.
We did it, Five Claw! We put the moons back in motion and defeated both Mulamir and Kalgrontid. I want to thank you for everything. Elsweyr is safer today because of you. Just being on the plane of Jade clarified the memories I inherited at the Shadow Dance Temple. I saw the ritual in my mind and performed the actions. Oh, too bad the Dragonhorn did not survive. At least it lasted long enough to banish Kalgrontid. He did grow larger with every infusion of power he absorbed. But the horn dislodged him from Jade's core, which allowed me to finish the ritual and end the eclipse. After that... a concern for another day, yes? I cannot be named queen without the Main's blessing. That, however, is my worry. For now, you should rest. We must honor our fallen and learn the fate of our troops at the Moongate. And after that, we will celebrate a new dawn for Elsweyr. We have accomplished much, my friend. We overthrew the tyrant, Euraxia Tarn, defeated Zumak Foom and the Betrayer, even killed at least two dragons and made the moons move in the sky. If only I could shake this sense of impending doom. Nothing specific. Not really. I guess this sense of worry will stay with me until I know the fate of Garish Rhee, Zamarak, even Prefect Kalo. I would return to the Moongate, but other matters require my attention. Namely, the Envoy of the Main. That is just it. I have no idea. Moons. My head pounds. The effort I exerted at Jode's core was not without a cost. Five Claw, could I convince you to determine the fate of my soldiers and our friends? I appreciate your assistance, my friend. Find out what happened to Garish Rhi and the others, then bring word back to me. Meanwhile, I will try to find a few moments to rest before I meet with the main's envoy or worry about the other dragons. Far from it. But without Kalgrontid and Mulamnir to lead them, they are solitary beasts without a grand plan. Colossal, dangerous beasts to be sure, but not the overwhelming force they were under their dragon leaders. There is little difference between myth and history for the Khajiit Five Claw. Whether Euraxia discovered the Kunzari stories and that led them to the Betrayer's Head, or Zumog Fum reanimated the head and then learned the tales, who can say?